Target 12 investigators are digging deeper into the ongoing Institute for International Sport investigation. We went to the state police to find out what goes into white-collar corruption cases and why they take more time to develop. Target 12 investigator Walt Buteau sat down with the man in charge of the case tonight to learn more about this process. He joins us live in the newsroom with the new details.
And they tell us cases like this require airtight evidence to get indictments and convictions, and that the trails to track down that white-collar conviction are often crooked and long.
Reused.
The Institute investigation involves thousands of documents, plus emails, letters, and computer hardware. Some obtained from the Institute headquarters in a state police search in February.
From the sports experience.
More from a separate search at Executive Director Daniel Doyle's West Hartford home in early March. The state police financial crimes and computer crimes units are working on the investigation.
And ask the questions of the witnesses.
Which is headed by Lieutenant Todd Catlow, who would not comment on the Institute investigation itself.
The underlying source.
But he did offer details on how state police track down evidence for white-collar crimes that often involve money trails and reams of paperwork.
A document can lead you to an interview, a document can lead you to another document. It really depends on the case whether we're looking for documents' authenticity or whether we're trying to follow money. It takes a long time to put one of these cases together from start to finish.
Some of that time eaten up when documents lead to more documents or potential evidence that require subpoenas to obtain. Lieutenant Catlow tells Target 12 a single document could take weeks to acquire and even more time to analyze for information and authenticity. They also tell us presentations to a grand jury can come during a financial crimes case investigation, not necessarily after all the evidence is gathered.
We don't always use the grand jury in all cases, but we do use them probably in 50% of our public corruption cases.
The Institute investigation began at least 6 weeks ago, following a state audit that indicated the nonprofit could supply paperwork for about $163,000 of an almost $600,000 state legislative grant. And state police investigators are not offering a time frame at this point for when we might see indictments in the Institute case. Live in the newsroom with the Target 12 investigators, Walt Buteau, Eyewitness News.
The Target 12 investigators are always looking for news. If you want to help expose corruption or drop a dime on government waste, call our tip line 228-1763, or you can email us at target12@wpri.com.